Hello everyone, today we are going to see the bell drives. Okay, in previous one we seen that what is meant by bell drive, okay, which factors affects on the velocity ratio of bell drive, which factors affects on the power transmission of the bell drive, okay, types of bell drives we seen, okay, and types of bells is also seen. Today we are going to see the type next another types of the bell drive. So see here. That is what in previous one we seen two types of bell drive, that is what open bell drive and cross bell drive. Now today we are going to see the quarter turn bell drive, that is right angle bell drive. Okay, so see here, this is what a quarter turn bell drive or right angle bell drive. See here, this is what a right angle, okay, and this is what guide pulley. Okay, a guide pulley is used to connect two non-parallel shafts in such a way that they may run in either direction and still making the pulley to deliver the bell properly in accordance with the law of belting. Okay, that means the guide pulley is here used here what to connect two non-parallel shafts. These are the two non-parallel shafts, this shaft and this shaft. Okay, in the either direction and still making the pulley to deliver the bell properly in accordance with the law of belting. That means these two are the non-parallel shafts, okay, and this guide pulley is used to connect these two shafts to transfer power from one shaft to another, okay, and here is what they fulfill the requirement of law of belting. A guide pulley can also be used to connect even intersecting shaft also. That means this shaft might be intersecting or may not be, okay. That means this guide pulley is used for two non-parallel shaft and intersecting shaft also. Next is what bell drive with idler pulley. Okay, so see here, this is what a bell drive with idler pulley. So see here, this shaft we have to transmit motion from this shaft to this one. Okay, here see here, this idler pulley is used. Okay, again see here, this is what a driver pulley. Okay, we have to transfer motion from this pulley. Okay, so this is what driver, this is what a driven. Okay, that means speed reduction, we want the speed reduction. Okay, at the time we use see here, this is what idler pulley, here is also idler pulley, this is and this one is also idler pulley. Okay, so this is what a figure, bell drive with idler pulley. With constant use, the belt is permanently stretched in a little longer. This reduces the initial tension in the belt. This what reduces the initial tension, okay, in the belt, leading to lower power transmission capacity. However, the tension in the belt can be restored to the original value. That means this is what used what initial tension. This reduces the initial tension in the belt, leading to the what lower power transmission capacity. Okay, and this is what a constant. Okay, which constant use. Okay, and what this restores the original value of the tension. Okay, in the belt. That means whatever tension is there. Okay, this will be restored as it is. Okay, that's why this idler pulley is used. A bell crank lever hinged on the axis of the smaller pulley supports the adjustable weights on its one arm and the axle of pulley on another. That means this is what this arrangement is like. What bell crank lever hinged on the axis of the smaller pulley supports what? It supports the adjustable weights on its one arm and the axis of pulley on the another. Okay, or other. The pulley is free to rotate on its axis and is known as the idler pulley. This pulley is what free to rotate on its axis. This idler pulley is what? This what is? It is free to rotate in axis. Okay. Owing to weights on the one arm of the lever, the pulley exerts pressure on the belt, increasing the tension and angle of contact. That means because of this weight on the one arm, what happens? The pulley exerts what pressure on the belt? Okay. This and increases the tension. Okay, that means they restore the what original tension in the what belt. Okay, and the angle of contact. Thus the life of the belt is increased. That means thus the life of belt is increased and power capacity is restored to the original value. Because of this idler pulley, what happens? The life of belt is increased. Okay, so that's why this idler pulley is used. The motion of one shaft can be transmitted to two or more than two shafts by using number of idler pulley. That means the motion of one shaft can be transmitted two or more than the two shafts. That means we not require the many shafts here. Because of this idler pulley, we decrease the number of count of these shafts. Okay, and we can transmit the motion to our more pulleys by using the idler pulley. Next type is what? Compound belt drive or intermediate pulley. Okay, so see here, this is what the pulley number one, this is what driver pulley. Because of that, this belt drives this pulley number two, this is what a driven. Okay, again another one pulley compounding is there. Okay, two and three. Okay, this is mounted, these two pulleys are mounted on same axis. Okay, center is same. This is a gear pulley number three, this is what a driver. Okay, this drives the pulley number four. Okay, and this is what a belt arrangement is there, 1 to 2 and 3 to 4, compound belt drive. Okay, when it is required to have a large velocity ratios, ordinarily the size of larger pulley will may be quite big. Okay, when we have to require large power velocity ratio, that in that case what happens, larger pulley will be quite big. Okay, however by using an intermediate, that is our counter shaft pulley, the size can be reduced. That means by using this compound belt drive, we are going to achieve the size of the pulley must be minimum. Okay, suppose we have to transmit a large power velocity ratio, in that case what happens, we require the large size of pulley. Okay, so if we use the compound, this intermediate pulley or compound belt drive, then in that case what happens, the pulley must be small. Next is what, stepped or cone pulley drive. Okay, so see here, this is what a main or driving shaft, this is what main shaft. Okay, this is what a cone pulley. See here, this is what a cone pulley, and because of that, this is what a driven shaft. Okay, that means the motion or power transmitted from this shaft to this shaft. Okay, this is what a stepped or cone pulley drive. A stepped cone pulley drive is used to changing the speed of driver shaft while the main or driving shaft runs at constant speed. See here, what the statement is like that a stepped cone pulley drive is used to changing the speed of driven shaft. That means changing the speed of this driven shaft while the main or driving shaft runs at constant speed. That means this driving shaft rotates at same speed, but the speed of the driven shaft may be different. That means speed reduction is there. Okay, this is done by shifting the belt from one part of the step to the other part. Okay, that means this is done by shifting belt from one part to another part. Same thing is, we seen the same thing in the lathe machines. While the if we use, that is what again, turning, that is turning in what, reverse direction, at that case what happens, the speed must be minimum. Okay, and in that case how we reduce the speed of this what spindle by the arrangement of this belt. Okay, that means we shift the belt from one part to another. This is what a stepped or cone pulley. Next is what, fast and loose pulley drive. Okay, the fast and loose pulley drive, see here, this is a figure. This is what figure says, that a fast and loose pulley drive. So this is, see here, this is a driving pulley, this is a line shaft. Okay, next is what, this is what fast pulley and this is what loose pulley. This is what a machine shaft. This is what, first is the line shaft and this is what a machine shaft. Many times it is required to drive several machines from a single main shaft. This is what a single main shaft. We have to drive several machines. This is what machine number one and machine number two. Machine one is what fast, machine two must be a loose pulley. That is what must be loose. In such a case, some arrangement to link or de-link a machine to or form the main shaft has to be incorporated, as all machines may not be operating simultaneously. That is what such arrangement is used there. Okay, the arrangement usually provided is that of the using loose pulley along with fast pulley. The arrangement is used what, along with what, the loose pulley and fast pulley. Okay, here in this case, some arrangement to link or de-link machine. Okay, in some cases we link the machines, or in some cases we de-link the machines. That's why we use here what loose pulley along with fast pulley. Now next, this is what the types. Now next is what velocity ratio of the belt drive. Okay, so see here, it is the ratio between the velocities of the driver and the follower or driven. This velocity ratio is nothing but what? It is the ratio between velocities of driver divided by driven. It may be expressed mathematically as discussed below. Let d1 is equal to what? Diameter of the driver. Okay, d2 is equal to what? Diameter of the follower. N1 is equal to what? Speed of the driver, that is in RPM. And N2 is equal to what? Speed of the driver, speed of the follower in RPM. That d1 is diameter, d2 is diameter. Okay, driver and driven. Okay, N1, N2, this is what? Speed of the driver and driver respectively. Length of the belt that passes over the driver in 1 minute, this is given as what? Is equal to what? Pi into d1 into N1. Okay, pi is what? Constant. D1 is what? Diameter. And N1 is what? Speed. Okay, this length is given what? Pi into d1 into N2. Similarly, the length of belt passes over the follower in 1 minute is equal to pi into d2 into N2. Okay, now next is what? Since the length of belt that passes over the driver in 1 minute is equal to length of the belt that passes over the follower in 1 minute. Therefore, that means the length of the belt passes over the driver in 1 minute is equal to what? Length of the belt passes over the follower in 1 minute. That means that is length of the driver and length of the driven in 1 minute is both are the same. Okay, therefore pi into d1 into n1 is equal to pi into d2 into n2. Okay, therefore velocity ratio is nothing but what? N2 divided by n1. Okay, is equal to what? Pi is constant both in both sides. The pi is constant. Constant term both cancels here. Pi gets cancels here. So what remains? Velocity ratio is equal to what? N2 divided by n1. This N2 divided by N1 is equal to what? D1 divided by D2. Okay, this is what the velocity ratio. If we consider the thickness, when the thickness of belt T is considered, then velocity ratio, slight change will be there. This velocity ratio N2 divided by N1 is equal to what? D1 plus T divided by D2 plus T. Only what here? Thickness is added here. Okay, when we consider thickness, then velocity ratio N2 divided by N1 is equal to what? D1 plus T divided by D2 plus T. This is the standard formula. This formula is asked, we must know this formula while solving the problems. Okay, again this formula is asked in MCQs, that is multiple choice questions, in many competitive examinations. While in GATE examinations, they will ask the word, find the velocity ratio considering the thickness. So both formulas were there. Okay, well, might small change will be there here. N1 by N2 will be there. Okay, or here N2 by N1 will be there. D1 minus T, D2 minus T, like option will be there. So we must know the formula. Velocity ratio N2 by N1 is equal, N2 divided by N1 is equal to what? D1 divided by D2. While considering thickness, N2 divided by N1 is equal to T1 plus D1 plus T divided by D2 plus T. Okay, note, there is one important note will be there. The velocity ratio of belt drive may also be obtained as discussed below. We know that the peripheral velocity of the belt on the driving pulley, that is V1, is given as pi into D1 N1 divided by 60 in meter per second. And the peripheral velocity of the belt on the driven or follower pulley, that is V2, is equal to what? Pi into D2 into N2 divided by 60 meter per second. When there is no slip, then V1 is equal to V2. That means pi into D1 into N1 divided by 60 is equal to what? Pi into D2 into N2 divided by 60. So see here, pi get cancelled here, 60 get cancelled here. So what remains here? N2 divided by N1 is equal to what? D1 divided by D2. That means same formula will be there, while consideration is different. That means here consideration is what? Considering the peripheral velocity. And when there is no slip, then what happens? N2 by N1 is equal to what? D1 by D2. That means formula will be the same. Now next thing is that slip of belt. Okay, now next point we are going to discuss, that is what? Slip of belt. In previous article, we have discussed the motion of belt and the shaft, assuming a firm frictional grip between the belts and the shaft. Okay, but sometimes the frictional grip becomes insufficient. The frictional grip becomes insufficient. That means belt will be the slip. Okay, This may cause some forward motion of the driver without carrying the belt with it. Okay, that means the forward motion is also going on, but the belt is not with the pulley. That means slippage occurs. Okay, this may also cause some forward motion of the belt without carrying the driven pulley with it. This is called slip of the belt and generally expressed as in percentage. The slip is going taken as in percentage. Okay, the result of the belt slipping is to reduce the velocity ratio of the system. Okay, because of the slippage, what happens? The reduction in velocity ratio is occurs. Okay, as the slipping of belt is a common phenomena, the word slipping of the belt is common phenomena. Thus, the belt should never be used where the definite velocity ratio of the importance. Okay, as in case of hour, minute, second, arms as a watch. Okay, that means the belt. This belt is not used. See here, slipping of the belt common phenomenon, thus should not be never be used in definite velocity ratio of the importance. That is, this belt is not used in what hour, hand, minute and second arms. Okay, because the time is very important in that case. Okay, and let's see here, S1 percentage, that is slip between the driver and shaft, driven and shaft. S2 is what slip between the belt and follower. Let the velocity of the belt passing over the driver per second, that is V is equal to pi into D1 into N1 divided by 60 minus pi into D1 into N2 divided by 60 into S1 divided by 100. This is what the slip which occurs, that is what S1 divided by 100, and this is what this total is what minus from this one. This is what original pi into D1 into N1 divided by 60. So what common term will be there? This is what a common term. So take common, okay, pi into D1 into N1 divided by 60 into bracket 1 minus S1 divided by 100. The velocity of the belt passing over the follower per second. Okay, this is what the driver per second. This is what the follower. Okay, that means driven. Okay, this is what pi into D2 into N2 divided by 60 is equal to what V minus V into S2 divided by 100. So V is common. V is nothing but what pi into D2 divided by N2 divided by 60. Okay, into 1 minus S2 divided by 100. From this equation 1.1, and this is what this equation 5.4. So what we get here, pi into D2 into N2 divided by 60 is equal to what? Pi into D1 N1 divided by 60 into 1 minus S1 divided by 100 into 1 minus S2 divided by 100. So see here, N2 divided by N1 is equal to what? D1 divided by T2 is equal to, simplify this term. So what we get here, N2 divided by N1 is equal to what? D1 divided by D2 into bracket 1 minus S1 divided by 100 minus S2 divided by 100. Neglecting S1 into S2 divided by 100 into 100. This means cross multiplication will be there. And neglect this term, what we get from this multiplication by simplification. So take this term only. Okay. So N2 divided by N1 is equal to what? D1 divided by D2 into bracket 1 minus S1 plus S2 divided by 100. Okay. So what is here? N2 by N1 is equal to D1 divided by D2 into bracket 1 minus S divided by 100. So S1 plus S2 is nothing but what? S. Okay. Where S is equal to what? S1 plus S2 minus 0.01 into S1 S2. Total percentage of the slip is there. Okay. So what we got here? N2 by N1 is equal to what? D1 plus P and D2 divided by plus T into bracket 1 minus S into 100. This is what a final formula. N2 by N1. Okay. That is D1 divided by D2 into bracket 1 minus S divided by 100. Okay. If we consider the thickness, then what these terms comes like that. This N2 by N1 is equal to what? D1 plus T. This thickness is considered here. Again divided by D2 plus T into bracket 1 minus S divided by 100. This is what the formula to find out the velocity ratio by considering the thickness and by considering the slip, whatever slip is given in the formula. If the thickness is not given, then directly use this formula. N2 by N1 is equal to D1 divided by D2 into bracket 1 minus S divided by 100. Now next term is what? Creep of the belt. Okay. When the belt passes from the slack side to tight side, a certain portion of the belt extends and it contracts again when the belt passes from the tight side to slack side. Okay. So what happens is this phenomena also always occurs, that when the belt passes from the slack to tight side, certain portion of the belt extends, and it contracts when the belt passes from the tight side to slack side. Okay. Because of that, what happens? Due to this change of length, there is a relative motion between belt and pulley surface. This relative motion is called creep. Okay, the total effect of the creep is to reduce slightly the speed of the driven pulley or follower. The considering the slip creep, okay, if we consider the creep, so what we got here, this is what the velocity ratio, we already seen the velocity ratio is what, N2 divided by N1 is equal to what, D1 divided by D2. Okay, so if we consider the creep, so what this formula, if we have to rearrange this formula, and we got here velocity ratio is equal to what, N2 divided by N1 is equal to D1 divided by D2 into bracket E plus under root sigma 2 divided by E plus under root sigma 1. This is what creep. Okay, so see here, where sigma 1 is equal to what, stress on the tight side of the follower of the belt. Okay, sigma 2 is equal to what, stress on the slack side of the belt. Okay, this is what sigma 1 and sigma 2, these are the stresses on the tight side and slack side respectively, and E is nothing but what, Young modulus of the belt material. This is what the creep. That means this problem is also asked, this formula is too much important, the problem is this numericals is asked on this creep of belt. Again, this also used in get your GATE examination. So this is too much important. Okay.